everybody, it's Angie, and today I'm going to do a everyday eyeshadow look for you, because I've gotten a lot of questions and comments lately from people who are anywhere from 40 to 70 years old who are noticing that they really haven't worn makeup in the past, but that they really do need to start wearing makeup now. Because as you know, as we age, everything just tends to get washed out on our faces. And so while we not only want to cover up our age spots and wrinkles with some foundation or tinted moisturizer or something that works to do that, we also need to make something pop on our face. And I think there's no better place to really accentuate than the eyes. Because even though we do tend to have a lot of wrinkles and crow's feet around there, I think a smiling eye is one of the most beautiful things on the planet. And so, you know, if your eyes pop and you're, you know, smiling at someone and, you know, you're really feeling good about yourself, they're not going to remember your crow's feet and your wrinkles and your age spots. What they're going to remember is, you know, your beautiful eyes looking at them with, you know, happiness, and it's just going to make your whole day. So rather than concentrating on the lips or the cheeks or whatever, I think the eyes really have it. So if you are have been makeup challenged and haven't used makeup in the past, don't worry. It's not rocket science. You can do it. What I would recommend, though, is that you get a few, you know, decent tools and really concentrate on picking colors that are easy for you to use and blend well with your normal skin tone. Now, for a go-to standard day look, this is my go-to standard day look. It is basically two skin-toned matte eyeshadows that I use every day. And then I just swap in the third color, which is the darker crease color, depending on what I'm wearing or what my mood is or how dark or light I want it to be. So what I would recommend is that you go to a makeup counter or the drugstore and find two shades of matte eyeshadow, one lighter and one medium, okay? Nothing really dark, just a medium tone that really complements and goes with your skin tone. Now, the two that I have picked that I use all the time are by MAC, and this is the first one. This is called Blanc Type, and as you can see, that's a very light kind of peachy flesh tone, and that is my go-to eyeshadow for my eyelid and possibly up under my eyebrow. I use that almost every day, and as you can see, I have hit the pan because I love it. And the second one, my medium tone, is also from MAC, and this one is called Malt. But these two comprise my go-to everyday eyeshadow look. So let's go to the tutorial and I'll show you how it's done. The basic things that you'll need is a few brushes, definitely some eyelid primer, which you can get either at the drugstore or at a place like Sephora. An eyebrow pencil is good. An eyeliner pencil, and 2 to 3 shades of eyeshadow that you've picked out really carefully. I think it's really important to develop something like this so that you can put it on in 2 or 3 minutes, you don't have to think about it, and you're out the door. You know, then you can start adding in more colors and more palettes once you get more comfortable. I like to use only matte eyeshadows. The ones that I like are from MAC, and there are some from Bobbi Brown that I have. Laura Mercier makes nice matte eyeshadows as well. So that's the eyeshadow. With the brushes, I get mine at Costco, and I just wanted to show you the set that they have out right now. I just bought it, and this is the packaging that it comes in, and it has like 8 brushes, 3 or 4 of which are for doing your eyeshadow, and the rest are for, you know, blush and foundation, and they're great to have as well. This whole set was like $25 at Costco. The first thing that I think is really important to put on for doing your eyes, and it does take an extra couple of seconds, but with hooded crepey eye skin, I think that the eye primer is really important. Now today I'm going to use this one, which is Too Faced Shadow Insurance. So here it is on my finger. You just need a little glob, and then you just rub it between your two fingers and apply it to your eyelids. Now, this especially, and make sure, you know, go all the way up to your eyebrow and all the way into the corner and then out, and you can even draw it out because it is invisible. And with the crepey hooded lids, the reason I find the eye primer is so important is because it really helps to keep that crepiness at bay, so that when you're putting your eyeshadow on, your eyelid doesn't form those ridges and create that stripy effect. So it takes care of that. And also, if you have hooded eyes, your eyelids just, you know, like all your skin, they secrete oil throughout the day. And as the oils build up, it gets more sticky. And when my eyelid folds forward, it tends to stick down there and accentuate the folded, hooded look where it's laying on my eyelashes. If I put on the primer and then nice powder makeups, it tends to keep my eyelid dry, so it keeps it from really folding and creasing down into a tight fold and laying on my eyelashes. So it looks better all day long. I'm going to do this sort of backwards and counterintuitively. I'm going to put my eyeshadow brush down for now. Normally, when you see people apply their eye makeup, they put on their primer, then they go in for the shadows, then they do the liner, then they do the mascara. If you are older, like me, you might poke yourself in the eye with your mascara 2 days a week like I do. I'm putting the stuff on and I've got all my makeup on perfectly. Then I go to put on my mascara and I put it too close, or I blink, or my eye starts watering, and I end up with mascara, you know, like down here and up here. And I have to pretty much, you know, start licking Q-tips and washing off the mascara, which also takes off the eye makeup that I've just worked so hard on. And if I'm pressed for time, I don't have the time to redo the whole thing again. So I've started kind of swapping it and doing it backwards, and I find that this works out so much better. So I'm going to start with the mascara first. I'm only going to do one coat, and then we'll do a separate coat just at the tips when we're all finished. All right. I'm not even going to curl my eyelashes today because this is a quick get out the door look, right? I've been talking so long, we're not going to get out the door ever. But let's get started. My mirror's down here, so I'm going to be looking down while I do this. So I have Voluminous False Fiber Lashes. This is from L'Oreal. All right, so we're going to just put on this first coat of mascara. I'm going to try not to poke myself in the eye like I usually do. Oh, sorry, I have my mirror in front there. And I'm going to do both eyes, so I hope this tutorial does not go on forever. Okay, and I'm snuggling it down, way down close to the roots. So now I've got that on, and let me just check it and see if I have it all over my face. Yes, my standard mascara application. Let me close my eyes. You can see that I have a big glob like there. I also have little dots of it right up here. So I am just going to take my Q-tip, and I just use my own spit. Sorry if you think this is gross, but you know, it's me, my face. And like I said, now I'm not wiping off the eye makeup I just put on. I'm just going to go in and clean that off. And this is why when you're older, you need a big magnifying mirror to apply your makeup. You really can't see in a regular mirror all the mistakes that you've made. So always go back with your big mirror, 10x or 15x, and fix your work, because you don't want to be walking around with eye makeup. You know, nothing says old lady like messy eye makeup. Sorry to say. All right. So now I'm just going to put on a sparkly silver eyeliner in the waterline on the bottoms. And this is from Wet n Wild. I can't even see where the type is on this, but you know, here it is. Wet n Wild in Silver Shimmer. You can use silver, you can use white, you could use, you know, baby blue, any number of colors. That just helps to brighten up right between your eye and where your darker eyeliner is going to go. And if you're someone who can't stand to touch your own eyeball, you are not going to be able to do that waterline, and that's fine. You don't need it 100%. Okay, so now see how they're already starting to come to life already. If you do nothing more than put on mascara and a little eyeliner just to make your eyes pop a bit, you'll be good to go. But you, if you want to add eyeshadow, we will continue on. Now I have a darker pencil. This is one I've had for 1,000 years, as you can see, because it's a little nub. And I don't even know where it's from. For a day look, black is a little heavy, especially if you have hooded eyes and you have a lot of black liner. It just makes the eyes close down too much. So if you can find a nice medium soft gray pencil like this, it's great. Other colors that are really good is like an olive green, or like plummy purples are really great as well. And if you like brown, obviously brown. So then you're just going to take this and do the outer third below where you put on the sparkly liner, just a little bit out here, right? Like that on each eye. Okay, and then for the top liner, you know, you just kind of squint your eye down and start at the inner corner and just dot it on right above the lash line. If you want to pull your eye out a little bit to give yourself something that's not jumping around, that helps too. Okay, and see how I'm not really doing the neatest job, because in this little mirror I can't, again, see what I'm doing. But it's okay, because when we put our, when we blend that in and put the eyeshadow on over it, it's going to be all good. All right, so I'm just going to take a clean Q-tip and just clean up any irregularities at the top of that line. Okay, all right, so now that we have our eyeliner and mascara set and have cleaned up all the big mess that I made, I don't know if you do the same thing or if it's just me, now it's time to put on the eyeshadows. And the lighter color just goes right on the eyelid. So I just like swirl it in there a little and then kind of half close and just put it back and forth. And since it almost exactly matches the color of my eyelid, I can sweep it back and forth in the standard windshield wiper motion and not really have to worry about the creasing. When I go for the darker colors up here, I try never to do the windshield wiper motion because that's when you get the creasing. Okay, so that one goes on the eyelid. Then the Malt, which I have another very similar brush to that one. This one, we're just gonna go in an up and downward motion, and you're gonna see this is not gonna add a ton of color. It's basically just a blending color to give you something to blend your third color into and with, so you don't have any hard lines. Where this is like an everyday go-to look, you don't want to have anything extremely dark or extremely light or extremely hard. This is going to look very natural, and you could wear this, you know, all day, every day. You know, and then you can dress it up or even dress it down with less eyeliner, or, you know, not even use the third color if you want to go for a really natural look. So again, you want to put this up high. Now, if you have hooded lids like me, you need to go up high, but then you also need to open your eye like this. And when you do that, you can see like there is a darker ring there where I put it. And then right underneath it, there's like a lighter ring. So you have to be sure that you cover that with your medium tone. Okay, so I'm just going to dot it all over that, and what happens is that as your eyelid folds forward, that protrudes forward, catching more light. So even though you've covered it with the eyeshadow, it still looks lighter. So that's where we're going to use the darker tone for, to kind of create the illusion of a shadow on that to make it recede. So now see the difference? It's very, very subtle between the two eyes, but you can see like this one is starting to look a little less droopy than this one. And you're just going to pat it, or and either go up to down or pat it right in there. And if you want just a really super duper natural day look, you can stop here and not add the darkest color. And that will look terrific. But since we are going to add the darker color, now I have a choice of two brushes that I like for this. I have a pencil brush, and this did come in the new Costco set. And it's not very soft, though, is the problem. But what it does is it precisely puts the eyeshadow just where you want it. And where I'm using kind of a darker gray color, I don't really want too much of it because, like I said, this is a day look. So this one is a Sephora eyeshadow, and their eyeshadows are great and really inexpensive, and they come in a terrific range of colors. They're not as soft and silky as the Macs or the Bobbi Browns. They actually feel grainy, which I don't love about it, but you know, for the price, they do a fine job. This color is City Fog, NO2. All right, so now I'm gonna take that little pencil brush and just roll it in there so you get it on all sides of the brush. And you don't want, you know, to go on too heavy at first. So basically, remember that line that shows up, that's where you want to put this. So you kind of look at it, mark it, and then raise. And then just go right along that ridge. And if you want a little definition on the outside of this eye, you could put some over here and do the little outer V. But for a day look, I think the V is sometimes a little bit too much, and so I like to just put it in the crease. And it actually needs a little higher up here. Okay. To really make that skin recede. All right, I'm just going to do the same thing on the other eye. Just mark it and then lift up. And dab it in there. Okay. Then once you've gotten it on fairly smoothly, then you can start windshield wipering it back and forth. You might need to press in fairly hard to really get it in there. Okay, so see, the eyes are really starting to pop now. Now, I feel like I have a lot more on this eye than this eye, so I'm just going to put a little bit more on this eye. But if it's too much, you can always just remove some with a blending brush instead. But I'm just going to try to even them off a little bit. Make this go up a little higher. Because you want to be fairly symmetrical. All right. Then this is another brush from the Costco set. It's a nice fluffy blending brush. And I like to keep one brush clean that I never dip into eyeshadow to do my blending with. So since this one, you know, had whatever colors I used yesterday on it, then I'll usually take it and just wipe it off on a tissue. But I don't have one here, so I'm going to use this kitchen towel. So I just wipe it off to get the other color off because I don't want my colors from yesterday diluting my colors from today. And then I just take this brush and I'm just going to blend everything up. Okay, and then if you want, you can go back in with your medium shade up over the top of that gray up here. Just give that something to blend into a little bit more. And then again, blend it all with your nice fluffy blending brush. Okay, so you see you've left a nice bit of untouched skin up there where you don't have any eye makeup. And if you want, you could put a highlighter on there, but for a day look, you don't really need to. We've defined the eyes and made them pop. Our eyeliner and mascara is already done, but if you want, you can throw on another coat of mascara at this point. But the nice part about it is you've already done way in, so this time you're not going to be in danger of like poking yourself in the eye because you're not really going that close. You're just going to do the outer tips of the lashes with a second coat. And that way, you're not going to get it all over yourself. You don't have to clean up. The other thing that you can do to try to help to make your eyes pop is to put a little eyebrow pencil on your brows. I have this one. It's from Milani. Let's see if I can make it be the right way in there. It's Milani Easy Brow, and this is in the natural taupe color. Now at this end, it has, you rotate this so you don't have to be sharpening it, a little pencil, and at this end it has a brush to blend it. Okay, so you just pretty much fill in very, very light hand with this. You don't want them to look really super drawn on, but it just helps to frame your eyes. So you just want to fill in where your brows are a little bit light. And then you use the other end to blend that in. So, you know, everything is going to be soft, softly blended, nothing drastic. And when I'm putting this on, I like to more imagine that I'm coloring the hairs than my actual skin. So that's how light a touch I use, just to try to draw over the top of my eyebrow hairs. I have two final steps. I have this little brush that came in a peel kit that I got, but it's so soft and fluffy. I love it. The eyeshadow tends to have a little bit of fallout, and so sometimes you end up with little dots of eyeshadow here or things over here. So I like to use this brush and just kind of brush off anything that's gotten there, because like I say, I don't like to walk around with makeup where it shouldn't be. So I just brush off with that. And then, so in order to set that, I take this brush, which also came in my Costco brush set. This is more of a foundation brush, but I like to use it for setting with liquid spray makeup fixative. And this is from an e.l.f. product. There's a MAC one that you can buy that's much more expensive. I think this was like $3. This is Makeup Mist and Set by e.l.f. with aloe, green tea, cucumber, and vitamins A, C, and E. So it certainly does have, packs a powerhouse of stuff in there. And here is what it looks like. And it's just a little pump. And what I do is I just spray it on my, on the flat side of my brush, like one spray. Okay, a little mist, and then I just take it and I press it right here to really set my under eye makeup and to keep whatever concealer I've put out here from settling into, you know, fine lines and wrinkles and showing up later. So just do another little spritz on this side and set the other eye. Now, if you really want to set your eye makeup, you can do this on top of your eye as well. Afterwards, you can just take it and dab it on there. And that'll help that to be set between the primer underneath and this on top. Your makeup should not be going anywhere. So that now is the complete tutorial. I did want to take a minute to just say thank you to all my new subscribers. I have cracked the 1,000 mark and I'm so pleased. You know, I think I've said it before, I really didn't know what to expect when I started posting videos out here on YouTube. And thanks for watching. I really do appreciate it. And thanks for subscribing especially. And I hope for those of you who are makeup challenged like I used to be, that this is helpful and will give you some confidence to go out there and really just have fun and experiment with makeup and try to improve your look so that you feel better about yourself. Because if you feel beautiful, then, you know, there's no stopping you. So take care, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.